Anyway, with that background, we must now see some examples of window functions. We saw two in the previous lecture, but we must see more in this one. So we'll now look at a very common window called the Hund window. We shall now take one by one expressions for different windows. So in general, we shall specify a window as follows. We'll specify a window to lie between k equal to minus n to plus n. And we'll specify the window by the expression w of k. So for example, the rectangular window is specified by wk equal to 1. And the Hund window is specified by wk equal to half 1 plus cos 2 pi k by 2n. And we can easily see that at k equal to minus n, we have cos pi. So this is 0. And so also at k equal to plus n and minus n. So this becomes 0. And of course, what we are really doing is to place one whole cycle. You see, if you look at it, when k goes over an entire interval from minus capital N to plus capital N, you're running over a whole cycle of the cosine, taking you from an argument of minus pi to an argument of plus pi. And you're putting that whole cycle of a cosine on a constant. And therefore, it will always be non-negative, but it will follow a cosinusoidal pattern. So we can sketch the Hund window for our convenience. As before, the best way to sketch is to draw the corresponding continuous function and then discretize it. So, you see, we have this cosinusoidal function here, bell-shaped, if you want to call it that. The Hund envelope. So, for each window, we have an envelope, and the window is obtained by sampling the envelope. Now, this idea of the envelope is important. You see, how you get the envelope is very easy. You get the envelope by replacing k by t. T becomes continuous. So in this expression, you can think of replacing k by t. It gives you cos 2 pi t by 2n. So t equal to minus n, you can say that anyway, of course, it takes the value 0 as before. At plus n also, it takes the value 0. And then, of course, at k equal to 0, it takes the value half. So it rises. And then, you know, so, I'm sorry, at k equal to 0, it takes the value 1. I mean, half into 1 plus 1. So this envelope of the window is important for all the windows. Because when we are looking for an even length FIR filter, we need to do a little bit of work on this. You see, instead of, for an odd length window, of course, you would include t equal to 0 among the samples. But when the window is of even length, you must include plus half and minus half among the samples and then displace the other samples by 1. So you'll get an equal number of samples on the positive side of t and on the negative side of t. So, you know, when you have an even length window, you need to draw the envelope and then sample it starting from plus half and minus half and then displace by the integers. And the same is true for the ideal impulse response. We need to take the ideal impulse response, draw the envelope of the ideal impulse response and then resample it starting from plus half and minus half and then displace by 1. So for even length FR filter design, we need to take this care. That's why the envelope is important. Now, let's look at a few more envelopes. The humming window. By the way, hum and humming are names of researchers in this field who have suggested this window. The humming window is described by WK is equal to 0.54 plus 0.46 cos 2 pi k by 2n. And now, of course, you will wonder what sanctity these numbers have, 0.54 and 0.46. Except for the fact that they add to 1, they don't seem to have any other sanctity, and they really don't. You see, in general, one can talk about a generalized Hamming window, where you give this the value alpha. And therefore, this becomes 1 minus alpha. That's the generalized Hamming window. And you see, the whole game in this Hamming window is to try Hun window or the Hamming window is to try and optimize between main lobe width and side lobe area. So that alpha is like a tuning parameter. It allows you to tune main lobe width and side lobe area. And of course, you can't, you know, take it arbitrarily. You can't use any value of alpha between 0 and 1. You know, you would want, in fact, you would normally want it to remain at least reasonably positive all over the interval. But whatever it be, I mean, it's really a game of compromise between the main lobe width and the relative side lobe area. And again, the game is that when you go to a smoother function, now, you know, in general, the Hun or the Hamming windows do better than the triangular window, in general, in terms of their main lobe width come side lobe, relative side lobe area performance. And the secret of this better performance is the fact that they have essentially a sinusoid, or you could say a zero frequency plus a first fundamental term. Now, you can introduce one more term and perhaps introduce some more compromise, and that's what leads you to what is called the Blackmon window. Again, Blackmon is the name of another researcher. In the Blackmon window, WK is described by 0.42 plus 0.5 cos 2 pi k by 2n plus 0.08 cos 4 pi k by 2n. So essentially, one has introduced a second harmonic term. And just as a good dish requires just the right proportions of different ingredients, a good window requires just the right proportion of different harmonics to achieve a good main lobe area and main lobe width and side lobe area compromise. And of course, you could then conceive of introducing a little bit of a third harmonic and tuning it and so on. You know, so window design is as much of an art as a science. You see, wherever there is no one unique answer, and different answers involve different kinds of compromises, the subject also acquires the form of an art, because there are beauties of various kinds. There is some kind of beauty in some window and some in some other. But a masterpiece among all these windows, there are several other windows, a masterpiece among these windows is what is called the Kaiser window. The Kaiser window is based on what are called the modified Bessel functions of the first kind and order 0. So, let's denote it by I0x. And I0x is described essentially by its Taylor series. It's difficult to describe it in closed form. It looks temptingly like an expansion of e raised to the power of x, but it is not. This is a Taylor series expansion of the modified Bessel function of first kind in order 0. Now, just a little bit of background, you will recall that Bessel's functions arise as a solution to what is called the Bessel's differential equation. It's a very important equation in the whole field of differential equations. In fact, the Bessel's functions occur in many different contexts, seemingly unconnected. Of course, there are different kinds of Bessel's functions again. They occur in the context of communication, in the description of frequency modulation. And they also occur in other disciplines of engineering. Here, of course, you see they occur in window design. So they have some very interesting properties. Now, Kaiser studied this modified Bessel function, the Bessel function, for its spectral properties and came out with the observation that it seemed to offer an excellent compromise between main lobe width and side lobe area. What I mean by that is, of course, there is a fundamental limit. You can't do arbitrarily well on both, but you can probably do better on both fronts, and that also can be taken to a certain degree of achievement. And the Kaiser window is probably known to give some of the best results in terms of window design. And the beauty about the Kaiser window is that it has two tuning parameters. Of course, all windows have one tuning parameter. That is the length, right? So let's write that down. All windows have the tuning parameter given by the window length. In fact, the main lobe width is inversely proportional. N. So the more the length, the less the main lobe width. We saw that in the case of the rectangular and the triangular windows. But that is true of all windows. So you see, it's not correct to say that you cannot get as small a transition band as you want. You can get as small a transition band as you desire. The only problem is what is not affected by the window length is the relative side lobe area. And that is the tragedy of series approximations, sinusoidal series approximations.